Good morning. Today is Thursday. What month are we in? March 21st. On behalf of St. Juliana Falconieri Catholic Church in Fullerton, welcome and thank you for joining us this morning. The Mass readings can be found at our parish website at stjulianachurch.org. Please visit the website frequently for updates and faith formation resources. And we invite you to participate prayerfully this morning as Father Mike and Deacon Tom celebrate the Mass.
Once more, let us begin with the refrain of 345, Turn to Me. The refrain, Turn to Me, 345.
Turn to me, O turn and be saved, says the Lord, for I am God. There is no other, none beside me. I call your name.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God his Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We've gathered together on this Thursday of the fifth week of Lent to celebrate the mysteries of the Holy Mass. Let us remember the way that the Lord has called us by name to be saved and give thanks. For the times we fail to respond, we ask sorrow.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. Be near, O Lord, to those who plead before you, and look kindly on those who place their hope in your mercy, that, cleansed from the stain of their sins, they may persevere in holy living, and be made full heirs of your promise through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. When Abram prostrated himself, God spoke to him. My covenant with you is this. You are to become the father of a host of nations. No longer shall you be called Abram. Your name shall be Abraham. For I am making you the father of a host of nations. I will render you exceedingly fertile. I will make nations of you. Kings shall stem from you. I will maintain my covenant with you and your descendants after you throughout the ages as an everlasting pact to be your God and the God of your descendants after you. I will give to you and to your descendants after you the land in which you are now staying, the whole land of Canaan, as a permanent possession, and I will be their God. God also said to Abraham, on your part, you and your descendants after you must keep my covenant throughout the ages. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response will be, the Lord remembers his covenant forever.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Look to the Lord in his strength. Seek to serve him constantly. Recall the wondrous deeds that he has wrought, his portents and the judgments he has uttered.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
You, descendants of Abraham, his servants, sons of Jacob, his chosen ones. He, the Lord, is our God. Throughout the earth, his judgments prevail.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
He remembers forever his covenant, which he made binding for 1,000 generations, which he entered into with Abraham and by his oath to Isaac.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever. May the Lord be near. Lift your heart where they proclaim this good news as good people, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ,
King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the Jews, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever keeps my word will never see death." So the Jews said to him, "Now we are sure that you are possessed. Abraham died, as did the prophets, yet you say, 'Whoever keeps my word will never taste death.' Are you greater than our father Abraham, who died, or the prophets who died? Who do you make yourself out to be?" Jesus answered, "If I glorify myself, my glory is worth nothing. But it is my Father who glorifies me, of whom you say, 'He is our God.' You do not know him, but I know him. And if I should say that I do not know him, I would be like you, a liar. But I do know him, and I keep his word. Abraham, your father, rejoiced to see my day. He saw it and was glad." So the Jews said to him, "You are not yet 50 years old, and you have seen Abraham?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, before Abraham came to be, I am." So they picked up stones to throw at him, but Jesus hid and went out of the temple area. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Last year, parishioners from St. Juliana joined thousands of others within the Diocese of Orange at the first ever Eucharistic Congress at Christ Cathedral Campus. It was held in October, and I had the privilege of being on the planning committee, and I can remember an early meeting. We were tasked with coming up with a name for this Congress, and we began to exchange ideas, and within 20 minutes, we had a revelation. We had a name, and it was a name that surpassed all other names. The name was the I Am Congress, and we hear something about I Am in today's gospel passage. And I say it's the greatest name ever because it's the name of God, and this fits within a lesson that Father Mike gave us yesterday, and I'm going to give you a little quiz. Mike, you can't participate because I already asked you earlier. What was the lesson? Love is greater than the law.
Oh.
And the other one is truth is greater than the facts.
Facts.
Well, love is greater than the law because God is love, and God is greater than the law. Jesus is the truth. Truth is greater than any observable facts that we see. And we can see God's greatness in the life of Abraham. At the age of 99, his life was beginning anew. He was starting with something totally new. He was fully alive, and God revealed himself. He was in his presence at the age of 99, and in complete awe and wonder, he prostrated himself in front of the Lord. And when he did that, the Lord spoke to him, and he gave him the words of the covenant, a promise that's beyond all promises. And with that, he began to fully experience this communion with God. So sometimes we think we're going to retire in our 60s, and we're going to ease into our final stage. At 99, can you imagine this conversation that Abraham was having, the power of God's word, the trembling that Abraham must have had to realize the beauty and the depth of this covenant promise, an unbreakable promise from God. And with the knowledge of Abraham's greatness, the Jews who were being spoken to by Jesus today had a very difficult time believing when he said, "I'm greater than Abraham. I was there before Abraham." Jesus was revealing his divinity to the Jews, but they had a hard time believing it. They had a hard time believing him that he was outside of time. Jesus was present at the beginning with God the Father, and Jesus is present here with us today as well. Jesus says many things. He says, "I am the bread of life. I am the resurrection and the life." And he says so much more to us. This Lent, we can remember what he said he is to us, each of us. And we can also remember that on Ash Wednesday, one of the formulas that was given when we received our ashes was repent and believe in the gospel. Repentance is a complete change of heart. It's a complete change of mind. that penetrates our entire being. It affects our whole way of living. So how is your Lent going? We're 5 weeks into this now. If you haven't experienced the type of change, the type of transformation that you wanted, it's not too late. It wasn't too late for Abraham at the age of 99. It's not too late for us. Because God enters into our Mass here this morning. And at this Mass, we'll hear the words of the new and the eternal covenant. Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me. In partaking of the Eucharist, whether it's either species, we receive the full body, blood, soul, and divinity of the great I Am, our Lord Jesus Christ. And when we do that, when we remember him, when we do this in remembrance of him, we are keeping his word. And Jesus says, whoever keeps my word will receive eternal life. Friends, this is the transformation that we're seeking. It's available to us today. It's presented to us by Jesus himself. So let us have the same reverence, the same awe, the same trembling as we kneel, as we prostrate internally in front of the Lord as these words are proclaimed to us, and receive the Lord today in the Eucharist. We'll be transformed. We'll receive a life that's beyond our expectations, a life that's eternal. God bless.
Turning to God, who is our existence, we pray for Holy Church, nations of the world, and this our own community of faith.
For all members of the Church, may Christ grant us fortitude as we go forth, announcing the gospel of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civic leaders, may the Holy Spirit be their guide in their efforts to promote peace and prosperity for all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have strayed from God's covenant, may the Lord help them grow, help them to know again his steadfast love and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick in this community of faith, may they come to know the healing consolation of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they come to share in the fullness of Christ's glory. For everyone for whom we promised to pray, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The Mass is offered today for the repose of the soul of Epitacio Gicoli, Sr. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear these prayers that we bring before you. Answer them according to your will and our need. We address you through Christ our Lord, today and forever.
Amen.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer to you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands, that will become our spiritual food. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer to you, fruits of the vines, works of human hands, that will become our spiritual drink. Our altar table is ready now. I pray that my sacrifice and yours may be found acceptable to God, the Almighty and loving Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church. Look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on these sacrificial offerings, that they may profit our conversion and the salvation of the whole world. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty, since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and every saint, we too give you thanks as in exultation we acclaim,
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plene succelle et terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer to you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, O Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, his brother bishops, and all who minister in your name. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your great mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saints Juliana and Peregrine and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and using the words that Jesus taught us, together we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace and God bless you.
Agnus Dei, cui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, cui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, cui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the table of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The communion antiphon, you have laid down your precepts to be carefully kept. May my ways be firm in keeping your statutes. And for those who are not here in person with us this morning, we offer this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 Bible study for tonight is canceled. Let us stand and pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, O Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you feed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of eternal life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Vita dulcedo, et spes nostra salve, ate clamamus, exultes filii Eve, ate suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in ac lacrimarum valle, ea ergo, advocata nostra, illos tuos, misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum frontem ventris tui, nobis, post hoc exilium, ostende. O clemens, O